Hello everybody, you've already done the guided practice for Algebra 1, number 3. So here's another freebie question from me to you. It is question number 6 in the practice section on the bottom of the front part of your page. Okay, so here's another way to solve this kind of problem. Now you already see that the symbol is pointing to the left. So you already know that you have one way to solve this. However, the difference between this and the guided practice is over here. This number and this number are not inside of the absolute value bars, okay? So that means before you do any of those things I already just taught you, first solve for solve for x, except for not what's inside the x. What do I mean by that? So normally, instead of adding another symbol to the left and making a negative 22, you would normally want to solve for this by doing minus 10 over here. So go ahead and do that. Go ahead and solve it like you're normally used to doing it before you hit Algebra 1, number 3. Just don't touch anything inside of the absolute value bars. So negative 10, negative 10. We've got a positive 12 now. This x is still inside the bars, and we've got the positive 2. Didn't touch that. That 2 is outside the bars, so let's go ahead and divide it by 2. Divide it by 2. And that leaves us with absolute value of x inside the bars less than 6. And then that means for our final answer, we can do x without the bars, copy the symbol, put the 6 there, copy the symbol, put a negative version of the 6 over there, and we have our final answer. Okay? So everything I taught you only matters to what's inside of the absolute value bars. Anything outside, solve for those first. Get rid of those first. Add, subtract, multiply, divide, whatever you gotta do, do those first. If you have any questions, let me know in class.